What's up dudes, my name is Dano and today I'm gonna tell you 7 facts about Clash Quest. But before we start the video, I have a challenge for you. If you manage to like the video and subscribe with the bell in the next 5 seconds, you'll have a chance to get a shout out in my next video, so let's try it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and stop. If you manage to like and subscribe, comment hashtag a challenge, you'll have a chance to get a shout out in my next video. Today's shout out goes to this person. Thank you for joining the Kachao army, you're an absolute legend. Fact number 1. If you played Clash Quest only once in your life, you may already know that in game the islands are grouped in 4 parts: the Goblin Kingdom, Lava Land, Shock Shores and Elixir Springs. But little do you know is that these 4 parts are actually very similar to some Clash Royale arenas. The Goblin Kingdom is very similar to Jungle Arena, Lava Land may be inspired by P.E.K.K.A's Playhouse, Shock Shores has the same building design like Builder's Workshop, and there is no way that Elixir Springs doesn't look like Spell Valley. Fact number 2. You may know that the Goblin King is the first boss you fight in the game, but did you know that a lot of people were expecting it to be released in Clash of Clans? Yes, Clash of Clans, the best game made by Supercell in my opinion. Basically, back in the old days of Clash of Clans there was only 2 heroes, the Barbarian King that could have been unlocked at Town Hall 7 and the Archer Queen that could have been unlocked at Town Hall 9. So basically the community started speculating what heroes could be released in the future, and the most wanted one was the Goblin King. This creature was a fan favorite hero and everyone wanted it to be released. But after the Town Hall 11 update, the Grand Warden has been released and the rumors about the Goblin King kinda stopped. Fact number 3. If you already have 20 star chests in Clash Quest, you definitely unlocked the shop. But did you know that the guy that sells you the offers is actually the same guy that sells items in Clash of Clans? Fact number 4. You know that battling in Clash Quest requires quest energy, but what you do when you run out of it? There is something called quest tokens, and these tokens basically can be used to play levels when you run out of energy. You can have up to 60 tokens and you can use them whenever you want. But if you don't want to use them, you can always wait 60 minutes for a quest energy. Fact number 5. While battling, you can actually see the future stages of that level by just scrolling up. But if you don't want to do that in the middle of the game, you can always see the stages of a level before you start the battle. Fact number 6. Shipwrecks are the newest feature in the game. You need to use a quest energy to explore them, but you can earn gold or even something more interesting after you explore them. By the way, at the time I'm recording this, I'm very close to explore my first ever shipwreck, and I'm very excited to see what I will get from it. Fact number 7. As the shipwrecks, dungeons are also a new feature added in the game. To unlock a dungeon, you'll need to find or buy a compass. After you unlock the dungeon, you'll need to fight your way through 20 challenging stages, but it will be worth it, because you'll earn a lot of loot and it will be a very fun experience. So that was the video guys. If you enjoyed, please leave a like and subscribe. Join the Kachao army because it's completely free and you can always unsubscribe if you change your mind later. If you want me to do more facts about Clash Quest, just leave a comment with your opinion about this video. So, bye!